This is Zapman 245, and finally are onto continuation of our Halloween saga review, since it has been 8 weeks by now since my laptop was broken. Now let's go on to our review. This Halloween movie that we're going to talk about is the 7th of the series. Stars, again, Jamie Lee Curtis, LL Cool J, Michelle Williams, and Josh Hornet. Halloween H2O, 20 years later. Plot is, Michael Myers is back again, now looking for his sister. Even though we thought his sister was dead, since they told us in Halloween 4, his sister is not dead. She is hiding in Witness Protection Program. Change her name. And she is in California. And guess what? There's no more killing in Haddonfield anymore. Michael now travels all the way from Illinois to California to get her. So Laurie Strode changed her name to Carrie Tate. She now has a son. Her son, probably the father, might be Jimmy Lloyd, as we know in Halloween 2. She is also a dean of a college. Now Michael is going over there and try to kill her once and for all. As I can say about this movie, I love it. I mean, I very do love this movie. And people say it sucks for some reason. I don't know why you think it sucks, but just write it down in the comments. Alright. For some reason, isn't it supposed to be like a little bit happy when, well, not happy actually, since finally Michael found her sister? Dude, it's a reunion. How can you not be happy about that? A brother versus sister, that's the movie. That's how it is. It's not a stalking teenager movie anymore. It is a versus movie. And I think this is the first time Michael ever traveled to another country, which is California. He doesn't kill in Haddonfield anymore, since he was supposed to. Besides, Michael is very, very, very smart, so. We have LL Cool J as a security guard who writes poems. We have Josh Hornet, who is John Tate, who is the son of Laurie Strode. And he has a girlfriend, which is Michelle Williams. Michelle Williams is a little bit too chubby in this one. So, to tell you, this is like the most sad and very first movie ever without Dr. Loomis, since he's dead already. But we have one character that was from the first movie, which was that nurse. She was with Dr. Loomis when they were going to pick up Michael. Michael killed her already. Now, here are some flaws. Where did Michael get the mask from? Right? The mask, I love the mask, but the eye sockets are too big and you can easily see his eyes. And here's the problem. This is like the very first movie that Michael's mask in some shots had to be CG. Why? Well, they say they can't reshoot because this is a cheap mask and it can break easily. That sucks. I mean, seriously, why can't they just bring back the old William Shatner mask, right? And then make it as the mask from 1978 Halloween mask. Well, anyway, and we also have the soundtrack. It was less OST, but for some reason, they decide to take the soundtrack from Scream 1 and 2 and put it in the movie as it composed. There was a sign about this movie. Since two girls were watching Scream 2, that was a sign that they were going to use the OST. I mean, they were going to use the OST from Scream 1 and 2. That was a sign. So, it was a battle between Michael with Laurie Strode and Michael Myers. As I can say about Michael Myers here, he is badass. I mean, nothing can take him down. He been hit by an axe. Dude, Michael Myers is acrobatic. He lifted himself up with one hand holding the pipe and one hand holding his famous butcher knife. And went down, man. He was a stealth soccer, like he was a marine or something. Michael, really, he is strong too. Pulled down those tables, been stabbed by a flagpole, and had been kicked in the nuts by his sister. You can even see his eyes all the way open, really, really open, just because he got hit in the nuts. Seriously. Now, they say that this was the last Halloween movie because Laurie killed Michael, decapitated his head. Now, here's what I'm surprised. Some of the death scenes were, they only have like less death scenes. But one of the death scenes was again used, but they didn't recycle the footage. They used it again from Halloween 2, if you can see this death scene when Michael killed Will. Now, since they finally killed Michael, here is the rating. The rating for this movie is 4 stars out of 5. Music is half good, because why? I love the orchestra though, but I like the piano better. And I do not like a movie recycled any soundtrack from any movie, because it's bad. And the acting was half good. Except for Jamie Lee Curtis. She still got it. And first, I was surprised that LL Cool J survived this movie, thank God. So, this is F925, signing out.